Okay, so I am getting ready to do a pour on this larger size canvas. I am using a new product that I'm super excited about that I know is going to make amazing sales. It's called Coconut Milk. It has dimethicone silicone in it. So I'm going to be able to make a ton of sales without even using any heat, no torch, no blender. Look at this, you guys. Look at the sales we are already getting in the cup. Oh my God, I know I'm going to freak out. So something else I've also learned is we're going to, excuse me, kind of prime the canvas. I'm gonna put a bunch of white on here to not exactly cover it, but yes, I wanna kind of give it a base to already work with. This uses a ton of paint. So I saw someone else do this in a video. Using a comb. They actually used a pick. But this helped them kind of smooth everything out in a more even fashion, if you will. Instead of using a cake spreader or a spatula. So that doesn't really get it even. Could be doing some techniques that kind of new, but I've been watching some YouTube videos. Let's see if I can just tilt it a little bit. Move some. Just figure out new techniques as we go. All right. Excuse me. Sexy allergy tonight. So I'm gonna put one more little stripe of white. The edges are usually our challenge, so help it out a little bit. Okay, so and I've already prepared 4 cups for this. So we're gonna do 4 cup flips. And I'm just gonna do them super fast. There's 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the wrist. We're gonna let this sit for a minute or two. And I don't know if you can see that already, but it's already popping out with some pretty crazy serious cells. So I'm waiting for the paint to pour down, just all settle out of the cups. And while it's doing that, I do want to get it over here to the corner. So I'm going to help it out like that a little bit. Same thing here. It back in here. Oh, so gorgeous. Here we should be good. Oh my God, look at those cells already. Can Can you see this? I pretty much feel like we're gonna get cell heaven out of this. So excited from the stuff that I've seen using this product. Oh my god, look at that, you guys. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Delicious, delicious, delicious. Amazingness. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Even the cups are beautiful. Where I kind of want to save the cups and do a project with the cups. And then, same thing here. Oh my god. Can you see that? I don't think you can see over there. So cool. I'm going to move this lamp in. Give us some more light over here. It's a pretty bright light. Also, don't want to get paint on it. Look at that, you guys. And then last one. Oh my god. I have to say I've been a little intimidated a bit by this canvas because it's larger. It's black. I usually work with a more of a white background. Kind of helps it out a little bit. But then again, I see Rick on his videos doing working with black. So it's just a personal preference. Look at these souls, you guys. Oh my god. Delicious. I do not want to move this a ton because it's already so freaking gorgeous. But of course I'm going to have to just to get the corners and the edges. Oh my god, I don't want to lose any of this because it's just magnificent. Just freaking gorgeous. It's always a little bit of a challenge. With a larger canvas. Do you guys see those cells? It's just amazing. To get the coverage that you want and you need. Without, of course, the more you move it, the more you lose. Well, you lose cells, but then you also gain different things. So it's a little, it's an interesting little phenomenon, if you will. And I also, God, this is going to be so magnificent. Learned something else from a video that I just saw yesterday. A lady do this technique with this that I'm going to teach you that I thought was pretty freaking amazing. Let that move a little bit more over there. And then I'm going to show you what she did. We're going to do it on this one. So, some paint, that's just fine. Makes me sad to lose paint, but it's just part of this process. So, in that vein, dang it, I wish I had a record to work with underneath this. So, I'm just gonna do, just in case we lose some paint over here, I'm gonna play with it extra. So, watch this. Getting a straw, just your ordinary everyday straw. And then I'm gonna blow on it to move the paint where I want it to go. Do you see that? So I can blow it off the edges. I can move it across. Still more cells are popping out. There's so much paint right here. Oh, I just dipped my shirt in it. That's pretty hilarious. There's so much paint in here. And I really haven't gotten it off the edges very much. Don't want to move this too much, but I'm going to have to. So I'm going to pop another record under this side. It's going to just to get that coverage. Just can't even tell you how gorgeous that. This is my new favorite product. Beyond a shadow of a doubt. Like it's just incredible. So it's giving it that chilling effect that it needs to go over the edge. And got so much paint here in the middle. I'm going to move it over that way a little bit. Again, I don't want to like lose it too much, but I need coverage over there. I haven't really achieved. Ooh, Lordy. Look at that, you guys. Just freaking amazing. Hair dripping off, which kind of kills my soul. So we're going to put it over this rocker. I'm going to let it drop on there. I'm going to do a second pour on that. So that's why I have it underneath. So, there's that, and then I'm going to work this over here. Just to make it 12 at edge. Always wear a paint shirt because you're inevitably going to get paint on it. No longer straw. And I'm also going to use a craft stick. Actually a fork. I like forks to do manipulating because they the pointy tines can help me kind of pull things that I want to pull and make colors happen that I want to make happen. And you know how when you're eating, you pick something up? You can pick something up with it. This edge is already looking really good over here. It can also help me cover the edges. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And then now, I'm gonna use that straw to make some more cells here. And little baby cells are popping up out of, and because of that, it's like a little chunk of pink there. I'm gonna pop that out. And I am also going to try to move the hair. I like how it makes it kind of psychedelic. I'm gonna try. Once we want to pour a little bit of white on the edge over here,